मिस्टर स्पीकर सर, वाइल कंसीडरिंग द वेरियस एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ द वेलफेयर मिनिस्ट्री, इट इज एसेंशियल टू फाइंड आउट द वेज एंड मीन्स टू इम्प्लीमेंट ऑल दोज वेलफेयर प्रोग्राम्स दैट कुड लीड अस टूवर्ड्स द एस्टेब्लिशमेंट ऑफ अ वेलफेयर सोसाइटी. फॉर द पास्ट मैनी ईयर्स रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स ऑफ पीपल स्पेशली दोज बिलोंगिंग टू द शेड्यूल्ड कास्ट्स एंड शेड्यूल्ड ट्राइब्स हैव बीन रिपीटेडली डिमांडिंग द सेटिंग अप ऑफ अ सेपरेट मिनिस्ट्री अंडर अ मिनिस्टर टू लुक आफ्टर वेलफेयर मैटर्स. द प्रीवियस गवर्नमेंट हैड सेट अप द वेलफेयर मिनिस्ट्री इन सेप्टेम्बर 2005 एंड दस फुलफिल्ड अ लॉन्ग स्टैंडिंग डिमांड. Earlier, this department was attached either to the Home Ministry or to the Education Ministry in the name of Department of Social Welfare. Hence, it was not possible to pay due attention to it. Therefore, the then Prime Minister Sri Rajiv Gandhi pondered over this matter seriously and took a historic decision on it, and thus the Ministry of Welfare was created and this ministry started working independently. Several departments attached to the Home Ministry, including the Department of Harijan Welfare and other departments looking after the welfare of minorities, disabled people and other weaker sections of the society, were detached from the Home Ministry and put under the Ministry of Welfare. Apart from this, steps were also taken for the fulfillment of several commitments made by the government, as also of those tasks which the government was supposed to do under the directive principles incorporated in our constitution and which were left unattached to even after 58 years of independence. Although our constitution called upon the government to take steps so as to make the weaker sections and the disabled self-reliant so that they do not become a burden on the society, it is regrettable that we have not been able to formulate any national policy in this regard. A national policy for children was announced, but appropriate steps were not taken in the right direction for the implementation of that policy. The work was taken up, but much remains to be done in this direction because our country has not been able to progress as much as it should have. For this purpose, it is necessary to have adequate resources. Today, the situation is that due to non-availability of resources, we are not able to allocate as much money as we would have liked for our programs. The previous government had constituted a committee, and the committee was entrusted with the job of suggesting a national policy for the handicapped, keeping in mind the factors such as the facilities that could be provided to them, ways and means of provide them with equipment and assistance, and also ways and means to provide them with education and training in the cities, so that instead of being a burden on the society and depending on their parents, they can make themselves useful and make a place in the society. The committee was to give its recommendations on these issues. I would like the present government to take steps to implement the recommendations made by this committee, and also keep in mind those recommendations while formulating the bill relating to the handicapped, because so far we have not able to formulate the requisite national policy for the handicapped. Many experts have expressed their views after much discussion and deliberations. The government should take steps to implement those recommendations. I believe that this House will unanimously agree that there should definitely be a national policy regarding the handicapped, so that they need not depend on others. There are many countries in the world where many special laws have been made for the welfare of the handicapped, and they are provided with many additional facilities. We too can formulate a national policy for the handicapped on the lines of those formulated by other governments. Mr. Chairman, sir, as I said in the beginning, the rate of infant mortality in our country is very high due to many reasons, including poverty, malnutrition, and undernourishment. Similarly, many children are deprived of proper education as they fall victims of bad habits. We have observed that in many families, the parents are illiterate or they are so busy in their work that they are not able to pay proper attention to their children. Some of these parents work as laborers, while some others are engaged in similar menial jobs. The previous government had formulated, passed, and implemented the Juvenile Justice Act. I would like the government to make adequate arrangements to see that the act is fully implemented in all the states, and that none of its provisions is violated. The children are the future of our country, and as such cannot be neglected. Tomorrow they are going to soldier the responsibility of the nation. Along with the industrial development and progress in many fields, we are witnessing the onset of many services in our country. Ours is a welfare state. It is our responsibility to see that vices of our children are removed.